Hello everyone, this is Erika, and in this video I will tell you how you can get into Barclays and how I got in, right? So Barclays came around February or March 2021. So that's pretty quick for hiring interns, right? And I was pretty much shocked because I was totally unprepared and had no idea what should I talk about in my interviews and what should I write in my online exams. So first thing first, what is Barclays? Initially, I thought it's Bacardi, which is an alcohol company and who wants to hire for its software segment. And I thought they will be offering each and every employee a bottle of alcohol every day they work, and I was pretty excited. Post that, I realized that Barclays is not what I initially thought of, and it is one of the largest banks in the world and largest in UK. So I had 10 days for my preparation. So in the 10 days, I broke into 4 segments. The first segment, I started collecting data and how about all the things Barclays asked. And in the process, Nishit Bhaiya and Ashish Bhaiya came into my rescue. So they told me to read hash maps and practice a lot of DSA based questions. So I started doing that. In the second part, I started learning about CS fundamentals. So I read all the blogs and watched all videos of Get Smashes containing Confident Networks, Operating System, OOPs, and DBMS. And thirdly, I started practicing DSA questions. So the DSA questions which I was practicing was from Geeks for Geeks, Lead Code, and the 450 Love Bubble set, which everyone knows and it's all in like this, right? And for the fourth segment, I started practicing HR based and business round. This was the first time I was applying for MNC, and the process was a bit different because till now I had experience working with startups, and generally startups ask very concise or on point things. For example, if they're hiring for a front end engineer and they have React which they are using, they will ask you from Redux, you know, Redux Saga, Redux Suns, what is React and all those things. So the kind of preparation strategy drifted away a bit because I had not rigorously practiced DSA questions before that. So post 10 days, the DE day came and it was the OT day. First OT which Barclays had was a personality assessment. So for personality assessment, what my senior suggested me was to learn the company values. So Barclays has the values rises, and I started learning about the rises values, and it was the 3-4 hours which I was constantly understanding what rises is, and I was thinking, okay, so these are the values which is inculcated in me, and I started solving questions accordingly. Post that, I got selected in the second round. And to be very honest, friends, people got rejected in this round. So make sure you learn the rises values or whatever values a company has before you give the personality assessment test. And make sure you fill all the questions accordingly so that once they give your personality, it matches what they require. And after that, it was the main online exam, which I was scared of, which contained coding questions. So firstly, the online assessment segment, the second test, was around for 2.5 to 3 hours. I'm not sure exactly whether you remember that. So it initially had a essay which had 5 to 6 questions. So it was, you know, generally what we used to solve in schools. But the catch here was, I needed to read the essay and solve the question in just 5 minutes. And the essay was 1000 words. So it was pretty tough. Post that, I needed to do some, you know, basic analytics or, you know, aptitude type exam in which they had some, you know, questions which if you have ever solved India Bricks questions, you can understand what are aptitude questions I'm talking about. So the third segment which they had in the exam was an AI based assessment tool in which they give you a situation and they give you 30 seconds to think what you will speak, and then a camera pops up like here and you need to just speak for another 1 minute. After that, it was the coding part, and the coding segment had one question for me, and to my surprise it was hash maps, and as my seniors told me, I practiced the questions and it took me around 2 minutes to solve the question, and luckily all the test cases passed. And post that, I got selected for the interview round. In the interview round, it has 2 rounds, and the first round consisted of a business acumen round in which they gave me a situation that one of the product is not working and how, as a technical guy, how will I proceed in the situation. So in that, I, you know, told about everything I knew of system design and how we can help the product scale, and whenever it is going down, what we can do to raise the uptime. And after that, I got selected in the business round. Post that, it was technical round in which I was asked some CS fundamentals, I was told to solve a DSA question, and then it shifted to my resume part. So my resume consisted of a lot of projects and internships. So the interviewer is pretty much interested in the resume. So do check out the resume which got me in Barclays. I will be sharing it in the description, so do check that out. And the interviewer was excited that I was a community person. I had participated in a lot of hackathons. I organized hackathons, and you know, I was contributing to open source at that point of time. I already did a lot of internships in several companies, and he was excited about that, and he started asking me from those things. So some of our projects consisted of Firebase. So he asked me, you know, what is triggering in Firebase and related questions, and post that I got selected in Barclays. So these were the major steps which I took. Firstly, you know, in the 10 days I prepared properly for my interview rounds and the online assessment round, and post that for interview rounds. Those 10 days helped me towards that as well. So this is the total preparation strategy. The Barclays gave me around 1 lakh, which is a lot of money for me, because the first internship which I did in my second year was I got paid 1,000 for a month of working, and then, you know, getting the rise of, I would say, you know, I guess 100x. It's really good that I got paid around 1 lakh. So if you follow this particular strategy, you can get in Barclays. So the major learning which I had was, I initially was thinking of not applying to Barclays because I thought I was not prepared. But as a lot of people say, that you miss 100% of the shots which you don't take. So I applied, and you should apply even if you are not ready, and get the time between your OT and interviews and prepare yourself hard and ace around. So I hope this video was helpful for you, and if you want me to make some related videos, let me know in the comments, and all the best for your upcoming internships and interview rounds. Bye bye and best of luck.